Now we'll talk about content management. Well, Orchard is mostly a CMS, a content management system, so it's probably natural that content is kind of in the middle of it. Everything in Orchard, well, almost everything in Orchard revolves around content management. And because of that, Orchard has a very flexible, very extensible, and very useful content management feature set. So let's take a look at it. For example, if we have set up this site with the blog recipe, so, well, we have a blog here, and we also have a blog post. So on the example of this blog post, let's get into a bit more detail on how Orchard handles content. So let's check it out. And if you open it, you will see that this blog post has a title. It also has a permalink, which is pretty much the URL that you can reach the blog post under. It also has a body, and actually this body is in the Markdown templating language. You can also use HTML in a what you see is what you get editor. This is the basic configuration in the blog recipe, but just as anything in Orchard, it is flexible, extensible, and configurable. So here we are using Markdown for the body of a blog post, but you could use HTML, you could use plain text, you could use whatever else that you think of. And yeah, the blog post can also have a subtitle, banner image, tags, and categories. Okay, that's interesting. Nothing too exciting yet, but what comes next will be. Because now let's talk about some basic concepts of Orchard, and there are 3 + 1 very important basic concepts when it comes to content management. There are content items, content types, and content parts, and also content fields. So what are these things? What we are looking at right now, this particular blog post is a content item. It's a piece of content. A blog post is a content item. A page is a content item. But in Orchard, a lot of things are stored as content items too, like the menu is also a content item. And what describes how such a content item should work like is the content type. So let's actually check out the blog post content type. And if we go to content, content definition, and content types, we'll also see all the available content types in the system. Content types are pretty much blueprints for content items. So you can see, you can think of them as classes, and then content items are objects. So here we also have blog post. So let's check it out. This what we see here is, well, the blueprint of how blog posts work. So everything we can see here and everything we can configure here will alter the behavior of every blog post content item. Now, let's see. Well, first of all, every content type has a display name. Well, of course. They also have a technical name. The technical name you can see here in the URL, well, both of them are just blog posts. Then content types have some kind of metadata. This creatable, listable, etc. are individually configurable, and let's check them out in just very quickly. Creatable just means that you can create content items of that content type from this menu here. Even if you have it unchecked, you can create such content items, of course, also from code, but sometimes also from the UI, if you create the UI for that, which in the case of blog posts is actually here. Listable is similar. It just affects whether you can list those content items under content items here. And as you can see, we have a couple of content items here already. These are configured as listable, while blog post is not configured as listable, still there was this UI configured for it. There is also some configuration related to how Orchard stores versions of content items, draftable and versionable here. Orchard out of the box has versioning for content items. So if your content item is content type is draftable and versionable, like blog post is, then that means that when you edit a blog post, then first actually a draft will be created. So if you check out this blog post, and let me change something here. And let's save it, but I won't publish it. I will just save it as a draft. And I will actually select save draft and continue to remain in this editor, because instead, if I would just click save, it would bring me back to the blog post list. And let me also open this blog post under this URL. And as you can see, the title here is still the old one. Why is that? Well, because I only saved a draft here. So a draft version, just as you would expect from something called a draft, is not published. It's not visible on the front end. You can edit it. You can check it out from the admin. You can continue to make changes to it and save it as a draft, but it won't be displayed on the front end yet. When you want to finish up that content item and display it on the front end, then you can use publish here. And again, I will just use publish and continue. And now, if we go back here and refresh, we see that the change title is actually here. So this metadata is related to that. You can separately determine whether you can create drafts for a content item, or you can just publish it right away. And you can also separately determine whether multiple versions of that content item will be saved into the system. Because the blog post content item is versionable, that means that when you save a draft, a new version will be created, but the old version remains, and you can actually recover that too. And when you publish it, still, there is a new version, and now you will have two versions in the database. So you will always be able to retrieve older versions of content items. You will be able to go back to them. It's very useful because, much like in Git, you will have snapshots of a content item's versions. Furthermore, you can also recover deleted content items. As a delete in Orchard is always just a soft delete. It's possible to hard delete as well, but by default, everything you do from the admin for content items is a soft delete. When you delete some content item, it will actually remain in the database, but it will be invisible from users. This is useful for compliance reasons, and also acts as kind of a recycle bin, as in Windows. You can recover deleted items. And another metadata for content types is securable, which means that you can specify permissions to access or edit items of this content type. We'll see permissions and access control later. We also have some other configuration options here that we'll check out later. But what's important now are these sections, fields and parts. So until now, we have seen that we are creating content items. We now know that content types are the blueprints of those content items. So when you edit a content type, that will affect the behavior of the corresponding content items. And I said that there are two other major concepts that we need to know about, and those are fields and parts, with the full name, content fields and content parts. So what are those? Well, parts are the building blocks of content types. So that's why the content model of Orchard can be so flexible and so customizable, because we don't have monolithic content types. All the content types are built up of little building blocks, little independently usable building blocks called content parts. So, for example, as you can see, we have a title part here, and that title part is actually the part that drives the title here. And it also means that you can create your own content types with the same title part, and there you will get the same title functionality. So this also makes pieces of content definitions also reusable. The same title part can be used everywhere where you need a content item to, well, have a title. And the same with autoroute, markdown body. As we have seen, autoroute is supplying the permalink functionality, the nice user-facing, human-readable URL functionality, and markdown body, well, supplies the markdown formatted body of the blog post. But we have a lot of other things here, and there is not a content part corresponding to it. So what gives? Well, we also have a blog post content part here. Also a content part that has the same name as the content type. Now this is a bit curious. What is this? What this is that we also have content fields, and those content fields are actually attached to content parts. Because the building blocks of a content type are always content parts. But there are also even smaller and semantically a bit different building blocks called fields. And as you can see, for example, the subtitle that we have here on the blog post editor, that's coming from a field, specifically a field with the type text field. Now, content parts are the basic building blocks of content types, and content parts usually encompass some bigger functionality. They can have their own editor fields, like you have seen with title. They can supply some complex behavior behind the scenes, like autoroute part does, because autoroute part is not just saving this text here. It also deals with all the routing that allows you to find this content item with this URL in the end. So all of the parts here are pretty big chunks of functionality. And usually you will always attach a content part to a content type just once. So a content item shouldn't have multiple titles, for example, right? Or multiple URLs. So just one title part, one autoroute part. Now fields are also building blocks. And fields are actually always attached to content parts. So these fields that we see here are attached to this blog post content part. That's why we have this curiously named content part here. The UI here simplifies a bit because we just see fields in the root here, like these fields would be directly attached to the content type, but that's not the case. And by the way, that also means that while if you click add field here and add the field, that will be attached to this blog post content part and listed here, you can also attach content fields to your own content parts. Now, that's a bit more advanced scenario. And fields as building blocks are more specific in storing specific information. Like you see, we have a text field. A text field doesn't do anything else but stores a piece of text. And that's it. Although technically you can do a lot of things in fields that you can do in parts and vice versa, but usually the concept is that content parts are a bigger piece of functionality and potentially also multiple pieces of data, while fields are always a single piece of data. Or maybe multiple pieces, but very tightly interconnected pieces of data. And secondly, with fields, it's very natural that you attach multiple fields to the same content part. Like you see, while we have only a single text field and media field attached to this content type, taxonomy fields for categorization, we actually have two. You can also create your own content parts and own content fields from code. We'll also take a look at that a bit later. But there are a lot of these built in, as you can see, already configured here too. And now you see that if we try to correspond these things, everything now makes sense, because here we have the content type, which is again the blueprint of the content item that we have on the left. All the content parts contribute to that content item in some way. Title comes from title, the permalink from the outer out parts, markdown body from markdown body, and these fields here also come from the various fields in the content definition. So this is what makes the content model in Orchard so powerful. So you have all this flexibility, you have all these building blocks, you can mix and match everything. Even though things are built into Orchard, you can also customize them. You can change configuration of content types. You can mix and match everything. It's very powerful and it's very easy to quickly throw together your own content types if you are not satisfied with what's built into Orchard.